I'm here today to pursue you guys to focus on being happy, not riches. Our founding fathers included the pursuit of happiness as a God-given right in the Declaration of Independence. Along with life and liberty, pursuing happiness was of great importance to them. Are we pursuing it, and how do we pursue it? According to the Science Direct research article on time, money, and happiness, time and money serves as people's two most precious resources. According to the Nobel Prize-winning economist and researcher on happiness, Daniel Kahneman, said, money does not buy you happiness, but the lack of money certainly buys you misery. Below $6,000 a year, a majority of Americans say that they're unhappy, and they get unhappier the poorer they get. Above $6,000, the line for happiness is completely flat. So I have a video to show you, a TED talk of him saying that.
Everybody talks about happiness these days.
Since you do have a few moments left now.
Sure. I think the most interesting result that we found in the Gallup survey is a number which we absolutely did not expect to find. We found that with respect to the happiness of the experiencing self. When, you know, we looked at how feelings vary with income, and it turns out that below an income of $60,000 a year, for Americans, and that's a very large sample of Americans, like 600,000, so it's a large representative sample. Below an income of $600,000 a year. $60,000 a year, people are unhappy, and they get progressively unhappier the poorer they get. Above that, we get an absolutely flat line. I mean, I've really seen lines so flat. Clearly what has happened is money does not buy you experiential happiness, but lack of money certainly buys you misery. And we can measure that misery very, very clearly. In terms of the other self, the remembering self, you get a different story. The more money you are, the more satisfied you are. That does not hold for emotions.
But Danny, the whole American endeavor is now, you know,
alright, so after basic needs have met, additional income is not associated with increases in well-being or happiness. So why? A recent Harvard study says that the happiest people have more time and not necessarily more money. Instead of spending time to get money, truly happy people spend money to get time. Pursuing happy takes time that negatively affects the quality of life. Having money and spending money on material goods fails to make people happier, according to the Time Money and Happiness article. Researchers says that that spending time and money on others instead of self, or on experiences like trips instead of material goods, results in increased happiness. Individuals focused on time are motivated to socialize more and work less. Both outcomes associated with greater happiness. UC Berkeley's site on the Science of Happiness says, material things and money don't make us happy in the long run. People who have strong social connections are happier. That's number one. The article concludes by saying that the happiness comes from spending time with someone who matters to you. To know that you are there for them when they need your support, and they are there for you. When your basic needs are met, it's time and not money that makes you happy. It's time with friends, family, and loved ones that has great value and meaning to life. Work and money is not the be-all or end-all. Time spent with others is what is important for happiness. And if this country's founder said that we should be in the pursuit of happiness, we should pursue time for strong social connections that make us happier. We should demand time in our lives to connect with friends, family, and those who care, who we care for. Schools and workplaces should give us time or make time for social connections. Extra time for others at lunch, in the evenings, and on the weekends all lead to increased happiness. Focus on time, a work-life balance, and do not focus on money or or money that consumes so much that you do not have time for God-given right to pursue happiness. That's what we must all do. Thank you.